This is Nishmashree Kottapalli from AIIMS Medical Academy of Knowledge. Today I would like to discuss about the sense organs. Friends, we have mainly five types of sense organs. In that, the eyes are the most important sense organ. That's why Sarvendriyanam Nayanam Pradhanam. So friends, now let us discuss about the eye. Here, eye is divided into mainly two parts. With one is accessory structure and the two is eyeball. And here accessory structure consists of eyelids, eyelashes, eyebrows, lacrimal apparatus and extrinsic chymosins. Eyelids, eyelashes, eyebrows which give protection to our eye, and lacrimal apparatus drains of fluid of tears which consists of salts, mucus and bacterial enzyme known as lysozyme. And extrinsic muscles are of six types: superior, inferior, lateral, medial rectus, superior and inferior obliquum muscles. And next, coming to the eyeballs, these are divided into mainly three parts, which is fibrous tunic, vascular tunic, nervous tunic. Fibrous tunic is mainly divided into another two parts, which is cornea and sclera. And vascular tunic also divided into mainly three parts, which is choroid layer, ciliary body, iris. And next, nervous tunic, which is also known as retina, it is divided into three major layers, which is photoreceptor layer, ganglion cell layer and bipolar layer. And next, photoreceptor layer also divided into two parts, which is rods and cones. And next, here fibrous tunic, which is briefly know about the cornea and sclera. Cornea is anterior and sclera is posterior. Cornea is anterior, it is thick, fixed lens, transparent, non-vascular. And the outermost layer, which is mainly made up of non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. Middle layer, which is mainly made up of collagen fibers and fibroblasts. And inner layer, which is mainly made up of simple squamous epithelium. And next, coming to the sclera, it is whitish part of the eye and it is posterior part. And next, it is more rigid and which gives protection to the eye. And then it is densely connective tissue, it is composed of collagen fibers and fibroblasts. And next, the junction at which cornea and sclera is known as canal of Schliemann. And next, coming to the vascular tunic, it is also known as uva or middle, and it is the middle part of the eyeball. It is majorly three parts, which is choroid layer, ciliary body, iris. Now know about the choroid layer. It is highly vascularized, bluish in color, nourish retina, prevent internal reflection within the eye. And here the most important point, which is known as mirror-like layer, present in the carnivorous animals which bring ill at the night time, for example cat. And next, coming to ciliary body, it is thick anterior body and it consists of ciliary process, ciliary muscles. Here ciliary process, internal surface of the ciliary body, and it secretes aqueous humor. And next, ciliary muscles, these are circular band of smooth muscles. It is pigmented and holds and alters the shape of the lens. And next, coming to iris, it is colored and pigmented, present between the cornea and lens. It is cornea and it is lens, the middle part, which is known as iris. And next, coming to the nervous tunic, which is also known as retina. And here ophthalmoscope, which is used to magnify the image of the retina. This is retina, friends. Here ophthalmoscope, which is used to magnify the image of the retina. And next, the photoreceptor layer. Photoreceptor layer consists of rods and cones. Rods and cones are divided into two types. Here rods long and slender, short and thicker cones, and rods more numerous, which consists of 120 million. Friends, once again I am repeating, rods are more numerous and cones are less numerous. Here 120 million present, here 6 million present, and here protein is known as rhodopsin and here protein is known as iodopsin. Rods has less resolution and cones has high resolution. And rods, which helps for scotopic vision or free light vision in the low light condition, and cones, which help for photopic vision, which helps in the daylight condition. And next, coming to the bipolar cell layer. the relationship between bipolar photoreceptor layer, bipolar layer and ganglion layer is 1:1:1. And next, coming to ganglion cell layers. Ganglion cells extended posteriorly known as optic nerve. Friends, this is the optic nerve. And next, optic nerve exists as eyeball, as the optic disc or blind spot. Here blind spot is there, friends. This is the blind spot. And next, here image is not formed because here only cones are present and rods are absent. And next, coming to lens. These are transparent, non-vascular, present just posterior to pupil and iris. And next, held in position by the suspensory ligaments. Friends, once again, I am repeating here, held in position by suspensory ligaments because it is the 2016th bit. And next, coming to the chambers of eye. Our chambers of eye, which is divided into mainly two parts, anterior cavity and posterior cavity. Here anterior cavity, which is aqueous humor, and posterior cavity present between cornea and lens. Anterior cavity present between cornea and lens. It nourishes cornea and lens, and posterior cavity present between lens and cornea. And jelly-like substance known as vitreous humor or vitreous body, it contributes intraocular pressure. And next, coming to the defects of the eye. Friends, mainly people are suffering from three major defects, which is myopia, hypermetropia and presbyopia, and the next one is xeroptolemia. And myopia, which is negative side, it is corrected by the biconcave lens. And hypermetropia, which is positive side, it is corrected by the biconvex lens. And hypermetropia, which is corrected by the cylindrical lens. So friends, I hope you have understood these main points, and please concentrate on this topic. Please don't neglect. Vyans Medical Academy always wishes you all the best for your NEET and all competitive exams. Thank you, friends.